Hey, welcome back to my channel. My name is Rob Balasabas. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to add destinations inside of your Streamyard account. Let's go. Before we dive into this tutorial, if you have any questions about Streamyard or live streaming or video content creation, let me know in the comments. I wanna make sure I'm answering your questions. And also, I'm always looking to understand what kind of questions you have so that I can create future videos around those questions. So let's get into adding destinations inside of your Streamyard account. All right, so the first thing is log into Streamyard if you're not already logged in. Once you get here, you'll be dropped into the broadcast dashboard. So where I want you to go is your destinations dashboard. So just click on destinations on the top left there. This is a list of my destinations. So I've got all my different Facebook groups and pages, YouTube channels, Periscope, my LinkedIn profile as well, because I do go live on LinkedIn as well. But let me show you how you add other destinations. You just need to click on the add a destination button in blue right here. And that will take you to this page that has a bunch of different options. You've got your Facebook page, group profile, your LinkedIn page or profile, meaning your company page, or your personal profile, your YouTube channel or Periscope, as well as Twitch and custom RTMP, which I will dive into specific channels in future tutorials as well. But from here, I want you to just see that you can have all of these different options right away, really easy to connect any of these profiles, pages, channels into your Streamyard account. For this example, let's pretend that I want to add my Facebook group to Streamyard as a destination for me to live stream into. So I'm going to click on Facebook group right here. It's going to ask me to grant a few permissions so that Streamyard can connect to Facebook. Don't worry, we will never post to your timeline unless you connect your profile separately. So I'm going to click on Connect Facebook. That's gonna take me here to a Facebook login page. That's totally fine. That's where you need to be. I'm just gonna click on login. There you go. So now I am logged into Facebook. And so what Streamyard does is it actually pulls all the different Facebook groups that I am an admin for. So these are all the different groups. Hard to believe that I am connected to all these different groups. I'm gonna click on the Collaboration Nation. And as an example to connect that to Streamyard, it's going to take you to a page where it's going to ask you for permission to add Streamyard, the Streamyard app, to your Facebook group. And so yes, open Facebook group settings. All right, there you have it. Looks like Streamyard is already added as an app inside of my Facebook group. So now I am good to go. If you did ever want to disconnect your Streamyard app from your Facebook group, you can always click on manage apps right here. And from here, you can click on the remove button. Obviously, I won't do that because I don't want to remove Streamyard from my Facebook group because I go live inside of my group regularly each week. So I'm going to click on done. So once you've done that, you can go back to your destinations. Just make sure that that group or that page or that YouTube channel or Periscope, your Twitter account, whatever destination you're adding, you can just go back to your destinations dashboard inside of Streamyard. Just make sure it's there and then you can go ahead and start broadcasting. Go watch this next tutorial, another tutorial on Streamyard. And again, if you have any questions, leave me a comment. I'm happy to answer any questions for you and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.